Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Monday, September 20th. The number of people testing positive for coronavirus in the Garden State is up more than 30% from just a month ago, and 99% of all new infections, an average of about 1,900 per day, are of the Delta variant. Meanwhile, New Jersey's rate of transmission held steady through the weekend at 1.07. Anything over 1 indicates viral spread. We are seeing about 1,100 people in the hospital again this morning, with about a quarter of those needing life-supporting care. The CDC says every New Jersey county still has a high transmission rate. But if you look at the state and CDC numbers combined, you can see that in those counties where they have the lowest vaccination rates, they are having the highest instance of new COVID cases. Take Ocean County, for example. While the state has nearly 60% of its total population vaccinated, it's about 46% in Ocean, and they have the highest incidence of new COVID infections statewide. With kids under 12 still not able to get vaccinated against coronavirus, many parents are concerned about having them in school. Meanwhile, state and federal health officials are pointing to expansion of testing, clinical trials on kids as young as 5, and Dr. Anthony Fauci, the chief White House medical advisor, is also predicting we could see at least emergency approval for COVID vaccination for kids as young as 5 as early as next month. Many questions still surround the COVID vaccine booster program. State mega sites were expected to be open starting today, but the FDA has only recommended a third shot, or a second of the J&J, if you are over the age of 65 or have an underlying medical condition, so the state's mega vaccination sites remain closed this morning. Warren County has now been added to the list of counties declared a major federal disaster area by FEMA. That's all as a result of Ida's flooding. A total of 12 counties now in New Jersey do have a major disaster declaration, meaning individual residents can apply for FEMA aid. You can do that at disasterassistance.gov. There are in-person FEMA offices that are now opening this morning in Bergen, Gloucester, Hunterdon, Mercer, Middlesex, Passaic, Somerset, and Union counties. A New Jersey police officer safely caught a one-month-old infant that was dropped from a second-story balcony. Officer Eduardo Matute was among those called to Jersey City Saturday morning for a report of a child being threatened. When they got there, a man was dangling the infant over the side of the railing on that balcony and eventually let the child go. It was Officer Matute, seen here in this photo with the child at the hospital, who made the catch. The baby does appear to be fine. The man is facing multiple charges, still no word what sparked this standoff, and the investigation is continuing. There remains a moderate risk of rip currents this morning. It was a severe risk as the red flags were flying up and down the Garden State shore on Saturday and Sunday. Water rescues were common. Now, most beaches are unguarded because lifeguards have gone home from the season. Among the rescued, a 27-year-old woman from Connecticut. Police say she was dragged into the ocean by a powerful rip current. This was off of Toms River. A 54-year-old man was rescued by surfers off Brick, though he did not survive. Gasoline prices in the Garden State on the rise again, up only about a penny a gallon. We're paying about $3.22 for regular this morning, and that is more than a dollar a gallon more than what we were paying just a year ago. Early next year or sooner, whenever legal weed sales officially begin in the Garden State, you will be able to buy cannabis. You will not, however, be able to buy edibles such as cookies or gummies. Lozenges will be fine. They've already been approved under the state's medical cannabis program. Do you like to be scared? There are a lot of scary, creepy, haunted sites in the Garden State. And ahead of Halloween, we've put together a list of some of the creepiest and most haunted sites in the Garden State. You can check it out at nj1015.com. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we are always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Monday, September 20th. Have a great day.